The wind just goes right through me. I'm about to freeze. Oh, I hate this. Oh, brr.
Oh. Hey, Big Bird.
Hey, Maria, where are you going?
Oh, I was on my way to the laundry.
Well, have you noticed how cold it is?
Boy, it sure is. It really is cold.
I just can't get warm.
You know?
What?
I got an idea. I know how
me
we can all get warm.
What?
Yeah, we can do some exercises and warm up and get the blood going.
Do you think that might help?
Yeah, and you can try this too. Yeah.
Okay.
Let's all do it. Let's first shake. Let's shake first.
I'm already shaking.
No, let's really shake.
Okay.
Shake your arms, shake your hands, shake your head, shake your legs.
Shake my legs.
Come on, you gotta shake.
Go around in circles.
Go around. Oh boy. Yeah, that feels a little better.
Yeah.
Now we can we can hop on one foot.
On one foot.
Yeah.
Okay.
Go around in circles.
Round in circles, come on, hopping.
And go the other way.
Hop around the other way?
Yeah.
Oh, on the other foot?
On the other foot.
Okay.
The other way. Come on, the other foot.
Come on.
Hey, this is good.
Yeah. And one good last one.
What's that?
Yeah, we could run in place.
Okay, yeah. Running in place.
Get those knees up. Come on. Come on.
Yeah. Hi, Big Bird.
Hi, I'm running.
Come on, you gotta run.
Uh-oh.
There.
Maria.
How do you feel?
I'm fine, except
feel warmer?
Oh, yeah. As a matter of fact, I have a new problem.
What's that?
Do you have any exercises to make you cool off? I'm really hot.
Listen while I'll tell you a story old and true. Now Casey McPhee, the engineer, got this train through. He faced the toughest duty an engineer could do. But he was brave and unafraid, and he got this train through. Through, 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 he got the train through. Through, through, through,
he got the train, through.
Train was carrying moo cows and milk and ice cream too. There were six cars filled with cookies and a tank of chocolate goo. The stuff was for the parties that the kids would have all year. And getting that train through the narrow pass was the job of the engineer.
Through, 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 he'll get that train through. Through, 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 he'll get the train. This train filled with stuff we love to eat, and children all waiting for it on other side of narrow, dangerous mountain pass. And me responsible for whole train. Me must get train through.
which had closed the track and covered it with snow. The snow was deep, the track was blocked, there was nowhere he could go. Casey knew the train was filled with things he loved to eat, but Casey knew his duty and would not admit defeat.
Through, 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 he'll get that train through. Through, 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 he'll get the train through.
Oh, this very hard choice, track covered with snow. If me stay here and not try to get through pass, me stuck here, all alone, with 6 carloads of cookies and ice cream. All alone, with nobody watching. Oh, me getting hungry. Me getting very hungry. Oh, maybe it's not too bad if me eat some cookies. Wait! What me doing? It'd be very bad if me eat cookies. Me must get train through!
Yes, Casey was a hero, and his duty he could see. Without the cookies and the milk, no parties could there be. The kids would be unhappy, so Casey raised his head.
Me forget about the cookies and eat the snow instead. It's mighty tasty too.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I.
Hey, that's my letter I.
Well, it looks just like a bone.
Give me back my letter I.
It's a bone.
It's a letter I.
Bone.
I.
It's mine.
Oh! I got it. Hey, I got the letter I.
It's a bone.
Hey, come back with it. There it is, an ice cream. Over there, an island. Hey, look, an icicle. I-C-I-C-L-E. One letter I for you, and the other one for me. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I.
You know, this bone tastes like... the letter I.
3 balls.
1, 2, 3. 3 peas.
1, 2, 3.
3 crocodiles.
1, 2, 3.
3 eggs.
1, 2, 3.
3 little pigs.
1, 2, 3.
3 birthday cakes.
I love summer showers, I love pretty flowers, but most of all, I love mud for hours. I love, love, love being a pig. I love how mud feels. I love how mud sounds. I love mud on the ground. I love, love, love being a pig. I love mud on my tail. I love mud on my snout. I love mud all about. I love, love, love being a pig. I love to feel the sunshine. I love mud all the time. And I love being a swine. A pig. Love being a pig. 'Cause I love how mud feels. I love how mud sounds. I love mud all around. I-L-O-V-E. I love being a pig.
And here they are, the alphabet dancers. I wonder what they're going to do for us today. They're twirling around and they're on the ground, and now they have just formed the capital letter I.
We all live in a capital I in the middle of the desert. In the center of the sky, and all day long we polish on the eye to keep it clean and shiny so it brightens up the sky. Rubbing it here and scrubbing it there, polishing the eye so high in the air. As we work, we sing a lively tune. It is great to be so happy on a busy afternoon. And when we're through with the day's only chore, we go into the eye and we close the door. Capital I, capital I, capital I, capital I.
Oh, look, it's all the way on the 10th floor. Yeah. That elevator will take forever.
Four,
oh,
nine,
yeah, it's coming down now.
Eight.
Yeah, seven. Six. Five.
Nine,
four.
Three, two, one.
Oh, that wasn't so bad. Yeah, it's here already.
All righty, going up.
Oh, good morning, Grover.
Hello, dear. Hello, Flo. Hello, Barney.
Good morning, sir.
Just a moment. Let me see how many are there. There's one. Just a moment. This elevator is only allowed to take five people at a time.
Fine.
Yes, now, I cannot take you up until you find out how many there are of you, so find out.
Let's see.
About a dozen,
wait.
I'd
dozen,
say.
Half dozen,
yeah,
maybe,
give or take
20.
Maybe even 100.
Wait a minute. Now, you can find out if you count. Okay, count how many there are. Go ahead.
Oh, yeah.
Well,
43. Are you 43?
Wait a minute. Hold it. Wait. That is not counting. That is just saying a whole bunch of numbers. Now, I tell you what. What I will do is I will take each of you individually and put you over there, and as I do that, I will count you, okay? So, sir, would you accompany me, sir, please?
Yes,
shall put you over here.
You're
right over here. You will be number one.
You come along.
You be next.
I've always
been number one.
Number one.
And you, sir, are number two. Right.
I'm
here.
Two.
Yes.
I'm one.
And you, sir, over
three.
Here,
yeah.
Are number three. Just
number three.
Step close.
Right.
Close.
Here.
That's it.
Okay.
And Flo, would you mind coming here, please?
No, not at all.
All right, Flo, come.
Yeah.
Step over here. You are number
two. Oh, that's
four.
Number.
Four.
A little closer to me, Flo.
She's
that's
four.
It. There.
Yeah,
and,
four. I'm three.
Barney, would you come over here?
Yeah.
Barney, you are number five. Okay?
Five.
So that means there is one.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Four.
Four.
Five. There are five of you, so you can go up.
Oh, yeah.
That's a lot of fun.
Very good.
Let's count that again.
Yeah, do that again.
I'm one.
I'm two.
Three.
Four.
Five.
Very good.
Oh, yeah.
Allow me to go in the elevator.
Okay.
Yeah. That's it. Okay. Going up. Any more going up.
Okay.
All right, fine. Thank you.
Sorry, you can't get in the elevator here.
Why?
This elevator only holds five people. Going up.
Oh, wait. I work here. Wait! Hello! Where are you? Wait, you can't do this! Wait! It's not even my lunch hour! I can't just stare! Hello! Wait!
Three coffees, please.
Three?
Yes, three.
But, there's only one of you.
Just give me three coffees, please.
One horse and he wants three coffees. I don't know. I just don't know. You want three coffees? I'll give you three coffees. But I know there's only one of you.
Loaded, broken,
There you go. Three coffees. One, two, three. Thanks.
Thanks.
Gracias.
Hi, Muffin. Who's that? Who is that?
No.
That's you. It is too. And don't you know you're beautiful? Don't you know you're smart? Don't you know the very sight is enough to light every corner of my heart? Don't you know you're all the things you dreamed you ought to be? That's you. When beautiful is what you think, well, that's what I see. Doesn't matter if your suit's not pressed or you haven't got a brand new dress or you can't find a nickel in the pocket of your favorite jeans. Hey, Dave-o. Doesn't matter if you're rich or poor, those things don't matter anymore. It's how you think, how you live, how you love, that's all life means. Don't you know you're beautiful? Don't you know you're smart, right? Don't you know the very sight is enough to light every corner of my heart? Don't you know you're all the things you dreamed you ought to be? Hi, how you doing? When beautiful is how you think, well, that's what I see, right? That's what I see. Hey, and you know what I see sitting around me right now? You know what? I see beautiful.
Come in.
Hello there.
Where?
Right here. Is this the Gerfner Employment Agency?
So is this.
Well, I want a job.
What can you do?
I can write.
You can? G.
Certainly. G happens to be one of my best letters.
Well, I don't think...
As a matter of fact, many wonderful words begin with G. You can tell by the G sound.
Good.
Well, that's one of them. Good. And girl, and garden, and gas, grape, goat, goose, gum, and,
Gorilla.
Where?
Right here. You're a gorilla.
I am. G.
That's right. Gorilla also begins with the letter G. And you are definitely a gorilla.
Gosh, in that case, I better get out of here.
Where are you going?
Well, I have to go learn how to run around in the jungle and eat bananas.
Terrible mirror. No reflection on you, of course. Ah, yes, my pets. Children. Ah, someone's at the door. I'd better answer it. Greetings.
Hi there. You got a very squeaky door there, fella.
I am the Count.
Huh.
Do you know why they call me the Count?
Mm-hmm.
Because I love to count things.
Oh, well, I am the mailman. Do you know why they call me the mailman? Because I have your mail here, huh?
Wonderful. Bring it in.
All right.
This way.
Where do you want it?
Down here.
Okay.
Ah, wonderful.
There's another whole box of it.
Wonderful.
A bag of it outside.
Ah, go and bring it back.
Yeah, right. Okay.
Back. Yeah, so, not now, children. We will play later.
Okay, here's another bag of mail.
Wonderful, wonderful.
And there's another one outside.
Oh, hurry. Bring it here,
okay,
quick.
Right.
Ah, wonderful. No, children, not now, later. Beat it.
You got bats in this place, fella.
Yes, I know, aren't they, darling?
Yeah, what are you, a bird watcher or something, huh?
Yes, of course.
There's another bag of mail.
Wonderful.
That's
thank
all
you
of it, fella.
Three
now, listen,
bags.
You must have a lot of friends to send you all them letters, huh?
No, I don't have any friends. I wrote these letters myself.
Yourself? Why would you want to read a bunch of letters that you wrote yourself?
Oh, I'm not going to read them. I am going to count them.
Oh, yeah, well, sure. I'll have fun.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, wonderful. Oh, I love the mail.
Hi there. I'm a parrot. Do you see me? I'm sitting right over here. See me yet? Look, I'll wink my eye. See that? Okay, I'll give you another clue. I'll move my wing. You still didn't see me? Well, all right. I'll fly around a bit. Then you can see me. Okay, now that you've seen me, I'm going back. Now watch so that you don't forget where I am.
It's a long, hard climb, but I'm gonna get there. It's a long, hard climb, but I'm gonna get there. It's a long, hard climb, but I'm gonna get there, yeah. Climbing to the morning sun. Well, the road is steep, I'm gonna get there. Yeah, the road is steep, I'm gonna get there. Yeah, the road is steep, I'm gonna get there.
This is a folding ruler, only it's all folded up, so you can carry it in your pocket. You can measure little things with it, or you can unfold it to measure big things. Folding rulers are very neat, don't you think? I certainly do.
Boy with people in. Birds have feathers. Raccoon. Nice soft fur. Fish scales. Turtle with shell. Porcupine that has prickles. Sheep have wool. Elephant has baggy or wrinkly skin. He has bumps. Rhino has bumpy skin. An alligator, hard, bumpy skin. Horse, soft, nice fur. Tigers have soft, striped fur skin. Zebra with soft, striped, black and white fur skin. Reindeer is losing her hair. Too hot to wear that heavy coat all in the summer. The ape has beautiful hair.
Hey, what's up, Bert?
Yeah, hey, don't bother me. I'm gonna sneeze.
Sneeze? Yeah. Hey, well, you can't sneeze, Bert. You don't even have a hanky. You can't sneeze without a hanky.
If I get my hanky, if I get my hanky, I'm gonna sneeze.
Oh, well, I tell you what, Bert. Hey, you wait right here.
Don't move.
I'll go out there and get a hanky for you. Wait right
here.
Don't move. I'm gonna get a hanky.
Don't move.
Don't move.
Don't hit me again. Oh, hurry, Ernie. I'm gonna sneeze. Hurry.
Okay, Bert, here's a hanky.
Okay.
Hey, you can go ahead and sneeze now.
Okay, but
go ahead, I'll hold a hanky for you. Sneeze right into here, boy.
It's gonna be a pretty big sneeze, though.
Okay, don't worry about it. Okay. When you gotta sneeze, you gotta sneeze.
That's right.
Go ahead, sneeze any way you want to.
Put the hanky right here.
Okay. Go ahead, Bert.
Ready?
Go on.
It's coming.
Yeah?
I feel it.
Yeah.
It's gonna be a big one.
Yeah.
There. That's better, Ernie. That's good. Thanks.
Bert. Bad news, Bert.
What's that?
Well, it's your nose here. Afraid you sneezed your nose off there, Bert.
Rats.
Yeah.
Ernie.
Yeah?
Do me a favor.
What's that, Bert?
And keep it quiet.
Yeah?
Put my nose back on.
Oh, well, sure, Bert.
Okay.
I mean, I'd be happy to do that.
Good.
I mean, that's what friends are for, aren't they?
Okay,
to put their friends' noses back on, right?
Right, okay.
Sure.
Put my nose back on.
Lean down, Bert.
Okay.
Lean down.
Right.
How about right there? How's that, Bert?
Ernie, I don't think that's quite right.
Hey, look at that. Look at that, Bert. Hey, you know, you should see where your nose is.
Yeah.
Why do you look funny, Bert?
I see it out of my left eye. I see it. Okay?
Yeah.
Well, you just put it back where it belongs, okay?
Okay. Here we go.
No funny stuff.
Lean down. Lean way down, Bert. Way down low. And how about we put it right about there? How's that, Bert?
Oh, that's great, Ernie. Oh, yeah, that was cute. Okay, now do it right, okay? It goes lower,
Bert,
Ernie.
I think you're right. It looks pretty funny where it is there.
Ho,
now,
ho. Ho, ho. Now just do it right. Put it lower.
Okay. Lean down.
All right. Now do it right, Ernie. Come on.
Okay. Let's see. It goes way down. How about down in, how about along in here, as I recall? How's that, Bert?
Ernie, for the last time, will you do it right? Cut the funny stuff.
It looks good on you there, Bert.
All right,
looks good on you.
Now, put it above my mouth. You know where it goes, Ernie, don't you? You know
where it really goes. Where the
nose
goes.
You know where it goes.
Okay.
That's right.
Here. How's that, Bert?
That feels lots better. Thanks.
Yeah, you look like you again.
Oh, no.
Now what, Bert?
I'm going to sneeze again.
Hi, diddle diddle.
The cat and the fiddle.
The cow jumped over the moon.
The little dog laughed to see such sport.
And the dish ran away with the spoon. You got the plans?
Yeah, boss, right here.
Let me see him. Hurry up.
Get in my pocket.
Hurry up.
Okay.
Hurry, come on, hurry up. Not much time. Oh. Get him out.
No, that ain't right. Well, what's wrong, boss?
One of these things is not like the others. Which one is different, do you know? Tell me which thing is not like the others, and I'll tell you if it is so.
This is a number, and these three are all triangles.
Oh.
So this one's different.
Oh, I got
you. Now get it right. Get them all the same.
Okay, boss, I got you.
Okay, get it right.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine.
See this rope right here? Well, this rope is connected up to that bucket up there. See the bucket? Well, inside that bucket is a whole bunch of confetti. Yeah, now see what happens is somebody walks into the door like this. See, they walk in and they see the rope and they pull the rope. And then, of course, when they pull the rope, it trips the bucket up there, see? And then the confetti comes falling out. Oh, get back!
Oh, that's the funniest thing I ever saw.
Oh, you think that's funny, huh? I don't think that's funny. You may think that's funny. I don't.
Now see those birds flapping through the air. We call them a flock, but they don't care. Sometimes I wonder if they know we're there. Well, to them it doesn't matter at all. Now hear those lions roaring fierce and loud. We call them a pride when they're part of the crowd. And looking like that, anybody'd be proud. Why, together they're just having a ball. 'Cause they're a family, a flock of birds is just a family. A family, a pride of lions is a family, yeah, just the same as my father and my mother and my sister and my brother. Now see those hyenas run across the flat. We call them a pack when they travel like that. Just a laughing and joking, giving tit for tat. Why, isn't that amazing to you? Now there's herds of elephants and broods of chicks, all happy together, all getting kicks. Now think of all the troubles man could learn to fix if he just learned to live that way. 'Cause we're a family. A family, a group of anything's a family. A family, the world of people is a family. A family, yeah. The same as my father and my mother and my sister and my brother and me. We're a family. All of us, a family.
I? Ink.
One, two, three. It's my cookie.
It is not. It's my cookie.
It's my cookie.
It's my cookie.
It's my cookie.
No, it's not. It's my cookie.
Hey,
cookie.
Oh, wait. What's the matter?
Oh, there's only one cookie, and there's two of us.
Yeah, and it's my cookie.
And it's my cookie.
No, it's not.
Wait. I tell you what. I decide who gets cookie, okay?
Are you kidding? Do you think we're crazy?
Yeah, you're the cookie monster. If you decide, we know who'd get the cookie.
But
we weren't born yesterday, you know.
Yeah, no, wait. But you see, I decide by saying that the smallest one gets the cookie.
Of all the crazy, do you think the smallest one gets the cookie?
Hmm?
You sure you mean the smallest?
Yep, sure, yeah. Okay, line up. Let's go. Line up.
Oh, boy. Okay.
Okay.
I'm the smallest.
Hey, you're scrunching down. I'm smaller.
Okay, wait. Ho. No. You both small, but I show you who the smallest.
How do you do that?
I don't know, but he's the smallest.
I'll do
Bert! Oh, Bert, what do you have there, Bert?
Nothing,
Bert,
Ernie.
That looks like a cookie,
huh?
Bert.
No, Ernie.
Bert, that's a cookie, and boy, am I hungry.
Ernie, ho, hold it.
Oh, Bert, why?
Not so fast. This cookie is for me. Mm.
Bert, but just a second, Bert.
What?
I think, Bert, that we have a problem.
No, I don't.
Yes, we do, Bert. You see, just a second, Bert. No, don't.
It's my cookie.
No, you see, Bert, you want to eat the cookie, and
yeah.
I want to eat the cookie. So what shall we do about it, Bert?
Well,
I have the answer.
You do?
Yes. We will share the cookie, Bert.
I have an answer.
Hmm?
No, we won't.
Oh, yes, Bert.
What?
Bert, just a second, Bert. You wouldn't share that cookie with your very best friend, Bert?
Ernie, I've been saving this cookie all day for me.
Oh, but Bert, no, Bert. Just a moment. Just a minute, Bert. Now listen, Bert, if this were my cookie, I would share it with you, Bert.
No, you wouldn't.
If that cookie belonged to me, I would share it with you.
No, you wouldn't.
Of course, Bert, just a minute. I'll prove it to you. Just a second, Bert. Now listen. Just pretend like this cookie is mine, see? Now you ask me if I will share the cookie with you.
You took that cookie from me.
I just want to demonstrate.
All right. What do I do?
Just ask me if I'll share it with you, Bert.
This is silly. Oh. Ernie.
Yes,
Ernie,
Bert?
Would you share that cookie with me?
Why, yes, Bert. I'd be happy to share it with you. Here you go. One half for me and one half for you, Bert. See there? I told you I would share it with you, Bert. That's what friends are for, Bert. Thanks a lot, Bert.
I don't get it.
Hey, Bert, would you share that half a cookie with me?
Small.
Smaller.
Smallest. Thank you.
A. B. C. D. E. 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 F. I said F. 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 G. H. H. I. J. K. L. M. N. O. P. Q. R. S. T. U. V. 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 Two V's. Two V's. Two V's. W. X. X. Y. Z. Proud of yourself.
Love. Love?
Groovy.
Love.
Not.
Love? Love?
Oh, ow.
Oh.
Butterfoot.
Love? Love?
Love, damn it.
This is the story of the unhappy empire. Many hundreds of years ago in ancient Japan, there was an unhappy empire.
Boy, am I unhappy.
Me too.
Oh, this is terrible.
The reason the empire was so unhappy was because it had no emperor. And until an emperor could be found, the empire would be ruled by the mean and evil prime minister. The people wanted to replace the mean and evil prime minister with a good and kind emperor, but that was not easy.
That is right, because according to the law of the land, in order for a person to become emperor, he must bring something to the palace that is one of a kind, something that can be found nowhere else, something that's the only one in all the world. Nobody will ever do that. Nobody!
But just the same, everyone tried.
Here, Mr. Evil Prime Minister, I can be emperor. I have this flower. There's not another like it in the world.
Oh, yes? Well, it just so happens I have one right here.
The citizens were so unhappy, they moaned and groaned. But they kept trying.
How about this?
You mean this? Sorry.
How about this hat?
Just like my hat.
It looked hopeless.
It is hopeless.
Then one day, a poor, tattered, but good and kind girl wandered into the palace.
Pardon me, is this where the emperor tryouts are?
Yes, why?
Well, I'd like to try out.
The prime minister laughed. After all, what could this poor, tattered girl have that could be found nowhere else in the entire world?
That's what I would like to know.
Me.
You?
Yes, me. There's no one and nothing exactly like me in the entire world.
Of course there is. Here.
Oh.
She's a girl.
Yes, but she's not exactly like me. There's no one and nothing exactly like me in the whole world. Nowhere. I'm one of a kind. My eyes are different than anyone else's. My hair is different. My walk is different. I'm the only one.
But
no one is exactly like me. My feet are different.
All right, little girl. Call it. I heard you. I heard you. You're right.
And so the people were very happy because this good and kind girl could now be emperor and the evil prime minister could no longer rule.
Hold it! That's so fast! She cannot be emperor! She's a girl!
So then she can be empress.
Yay!
And so the unhappy empire changed its name to the Happy Empire and lived happily ever after.
You big mouth.
Ah, you're just in time to see a really beautiful grouchy trick. You want to see what I got here? Look at this. See this microphone? You see this radio here? Well, see, the microphone goes right into the radio. Now, when I talk into the microphone, I can make my voice come out of the radio, and anybody who's listening is going to think that I'm on the radio. See, but I'm going to change my voice so no one will recognize me, and I'm going to give them a phony weather bulletin. I'm going to tell everybody it's going to snow, see? And then everybody will run around and go to a lot of trouble, see, getting everything ready for a snowstorm that isn't gonna come, because it isn't gonna snow. Oh, what a great idea, Oscar, this time. I'll hide down here and get ready to do my bulletin. Here we go. Oh, wait a minute, I forgot to turn on the radio. Yeah. Weather bulletin! Weather bulletin!
Hey, everybody.
Weather bulletin!
Yeah?
Come on, let's see what's happening.
This is a weather bulletin. We interrupt this yucky music to bring you a special bulletin from your weather bureau. There will be a terrific blizzard heading straight for Sesame Street today. And so you better get everything ready.
A blizzard?
Yeah, a blizzard. Ah. A big blizzard coming, and you know what that means. Lots of snow. So everybody get ready for a big snowstorm on Sesame Street. This is your weather bulletin man returning you to your regular yucky music.
Thank you.
Oh, hi, everybody.
Oh, hi.
Hi, Oscar.
How are you?
Hey. Well, listening to the radio there, huh?
Yeah.
Well, I guess you heard the news. Yeah, we
heard there was going to be a big storm.
Blizzard. Yeah.
Blizzard. Wow. Real big one, huh?
Oh, yeah. Look, Hooper, you better get ready for this, you know?
Oscar, thank you.
Yeah, right. Yeah, cover up your newspapers.
I will, Oscar.
And,
thank
get
you
some
very
salt ready, you know, in case the sidewalks get slippery. Yeah, and Gordon, you better get your shovel ready.
Right,
you
Oscar.
Shovel those old
Thanks
steps
very much,
again.
Oscar. I really appreciate that.
Yeah, you Bob, know? You better get your boots on.
Yeah, now. Right. I'll do that, Oscar.
Yeah,
thanks
you two
very
get
much
your muffler and your snow coat on there, Maria.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
You gotta get all those things ready.
Yeah. Well, you know, Oscar, we would do all those things if it were gonna snow.
Yeah.
But seeing as it ain't gonna snow,
it ain't
you don't
gonna
have to do those things.
Right, Oscar. You're just trying to trick us into make us doing all that stuff for nothing.
Honestly.
You
see, Oscar, we happen to know that was you on the radio, Oscar. We know that.
Yeah. Exactly.
We're just fooling you.
See you later, Oscar.
We got you, Oscar.
That's
good. Pooey!
That
didn't work. I don't know why they didn't believe me. Well, anyway, I'm going to make them think it's snowing somehow. What'll I do? An idea! A great idea! Oh, this is even better than before.
A nice bottom. Perfect middle. Head. Eyes. Nose. Mouth. Hair. Arms. New trousers. Tie. Ears, and a very nice hat.
Bottom. That's lopsided. Up middle. Head. Eyes. nose, mouth, and rosy cheeks. Hair. What a nice dress. Hat. Arm. Pocketbook. And the other arm.
You're very handsome, dear.
You're cute, too.
Thank you.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I.
Hey, that's my letter I.
Well, it looks just like a bone.
Give me back my letter I.
It's a bone.
It's a letter I.
Bone.
I.
It's mine.
Oh! I got it. Hey, I got the letter I.
It's a bone.
Hey, come back with it. There it is, an ice cream. Over there, an island. Hey, look, an icicle. I-C-I-C-L-E. One letter I for you, and the other one for me. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I.
Time to. You know, this bone tastes like the letter I.
Hey, come here. You know how I couldn't get them to believe that it was gonna snow? Well, this time, things are gonna be different. I got this great big block of ice here, see? And I got this fan here, see? Now the fan is blowing air across the ice there, making it really icy and cold. See how it blows out there? Yeah. Now they're gonna think it's a winter wind, you know? Comes in just before the snow. But look at this, the best part of all. See, I pull this rope, and at the end of this rope, I've hooked up in the tree a box, see? Now the box tips when I pull the rope, and up in the box, I got a lot of phony snow. Now this is really gonna fool them this time. Then I'm gonna have a good laugh. I'll better call him. Hey, everybody!
Yes.
Hey, you better come here.
What is it, Oscar?
Oscar, what do you want? What's
something. Up? You know,
what's happening, Oscar?
Well, I remember I told you that there was a storm coming in, but you wouldn't believe me, you know?
You're right.
Storm?
Yeah, yeah. But you notice the icy wind there? You feel the wind?
Oh,
it's cold,
yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Yeah, I would notice the icy wind.
Yeah, you do, huh?
Yep.
Yeah, it's icy. And, you look across the street. See over those building tops there? You see those cirro-nimbulous clouds coming in there?
Yeah,
look at that. And, it's starting to snow. Pull the rope a little more. Yeah, see, it's snowing there, huh? Yeah, you better get everything ready there. Yeah, really starting to snow.
Oscar really wants us to believe that it's snowing, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
Well, just this once. Why don't we go along with him and see what... Come on, Mr. Come on, let's go along and see what happens.
All right.
Okay,
right?
Sure.
All right, come on.
Hey, it's really snowing, man.
It's snowing, huh?
Yeah.
What? I'm going to go and get a hat on and some boots.
Good idea.
That's all right. I think I'm going to go get my shovel so I can clean the snow and everything, you know?
Right. Well, I got a lot of work to do. I'm going to get my boots, too.
I'm going to put my gloves on.
Right. A lot of work to do here.
Yeah, you do that. They bought it. I really got them this time. Oh, am I gonna have a laugh?
Hail to thee, Alma Mater, Roosevelt Franklin, elementary school, elementary school.
Here I come. Now, everybody, wait, because we have a lesson to learn. Give me that beat. You hear that beat? You like that? All right, here goes my thing now, wait a minute. Down by the barnyard, there was a duck.
Quacky quack, little old duck.
Chicken told the duck that he had bad luck.
Bad luck to be born a duck.
Duck hung his head down, walked away. Chicken wouldn't even let the little duck play. Told him that he didn't even know how to cluck. Bad luck to be born a duck.
Bad luck to quackity quack, said the little old duck. Bad luck to be born a duck.
Just then Daddy Duck came along.
Quackity quack, said the little old duck.
Asked the little duck what was wrong. He said,
bad luck to be born a duck.
Daddy Duck told him he was acting a fool. He said, go on down and swim in the pool.
Quackity quack, said the little old duck.
And Daddy said, get the chicken in the pool and see if by then he's a big enough fool to say,
bad luck to be born a duck.
So the duck took a dip and the chicken did too. And the duck was cool, but the next thing you knew, he pulled out the chicken and put him on land and said, if we weren't birds, I would shake your hand. You just proved one thing to me. A chicken is the last thing I want to be.
Yeah. Quackity quack, said the little old duck. It's good luck to be born a duck.
Just another number one golden rule from the Roosevelt Franklin Elementary School.
Right on, right on.
To me, alma mater, Roosevelt Franklin Elementary School.
Oh, you look great. Yeah. Come on, Mr.
Hey, mister, you're the one that agreed to do this, right?
Right.
Okay. Hey, wait a minute,
you.
Fellas.
Oh, wait,
fellas,
hold on.
Fellas.
What? What's that?
Why don't we go find out why Oscar wanted us to think there was going to be a blizzard?
Okay, come on. Let's go. Good idea. Hey, wait. Hold it. Wait a minute. Hey, look, Bob, look. It really is snowing.
That's snow.
Oscar. Oscar's trick backfired.
Sure it did. It's really snowing.
Knock on his can.
Hey, Oscar.
Yeah?
Oscar.
Oh, well, look at that. You got your cute little winter clothes on. You got your boots. I see you got your shovel, Gordon. Well, the joke is on you because it isn't gonna snow. Snow? What you doing snowing? Hey, it really is snowing.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters G and I. And by the number 3. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.